Welcome back to my channel. So, as you can see from the craziness sitting up here, we're going to be making a wreath today. So we're going to be using this burlap and all of this fall stuff, and I'm going to make a wreath for my foyer. And I'll show you what it looks like when it's hung up on the wall at the end. And let's get started. Now that I have all that stuff out of the way, we'll get started here. So basically, this is a wreath form. I bought it at Walmart. It is a FloraCraft Design It Wire wreath form. I want to say it was $2.86. It is an 18 inch. I also grabbed these brown fuzzy sticks. They're basically chenille stems. There's 25 of them. If they would have had a lighter color, I'd have grabbed a lighter color, but whatever. I just needed to tie the burlap on. I think these were $1 or $1.50. And then this big old thing of burlap was over with the deco mesh. And burlap, 18 inch by 15 foot. So there's going to be way more on here than I need to make this. We're basically going to do this in a deco mesh style. So as you can see, this looks, it's as wide as the wreath form. And we're going to make it all fluffy and vintagey looking with the burlap. Burlap is super in. And let's get started. So the first thing, I do have my hot glue gun over here to the side. It's starting to ooze, warming up, because I will need that for the decor towards the end. So go ahead and warm your glue gun up. I'm going to go ahead and pull these chenille stems out. So we get rid of that into the garbage. And then I'm just going to cut my burlap free and get rid of the little tag. Now, this isn't garbage. Wrap it up and hang on to it, because basically you cut that knot off and you can use it to tie up a Christmas ornament if you're making one any kind of like burlappy or anything like that. So hang on to that, don't throw it away. All right, and then I'm gonna pull this bit off here. Okay, so basically what's gonna happen is this is going to be rolled out. And you guys have probably seen this already, but we're gonna scrunch it up. We're gonna make these loopies all the way around. So I'm gonna do the first couple with you, and then I'll finish out the rest of the wreath and I'll be back, okay? So we'll go ahead and get started. There's two options based on the material that you get. So if you weren't able to get a 15 inch wide, let's say you could only get a 7 or a 10 or even one of those little short fibers, grab two of them, because then you can go inside and outside on your wreath form. So I'm going to tie my chenille stems just on the center two, and I'm going to weave them so they don't move around, because I have a habit of them moving around. So what you're going to do is run it through, you're going to twist it once or twice and leave them open like that. And everywhere that there's a chenille stem, there's gonna be one of those pinched up sections of fabric. Whether that's the deco mesh or the burlap or even any kind of fabric, honestly. Thanksgiving's coming up, and this would also look fantastic if you did the 18 inch in the middle of your table, if you had a very large like Thanksgiving table, and you did this and then put one of those really big like candle holders and then a big candle on top, it would just make an entire centerpiece as well. And then you could decorate it in whatever theme. And what's really cool about these is that at the end of fall, I can strip everything off of here and use it for Christmas if I want to. I typically just store them in my craft room, either hanging. You guys are probably going to get bumped a lot, because literally this is against the wall. Like, I don't have a whole ton of room in this setup to do this type of thing, and I can't find my cut mat, and everybody's in bed, so I figured I'd just get it done here. Okay, so we're done with those, so save them, because they'll blend in with any of that Christmassy type things. So I also have kids, and they like to use them to make fake glasses and things like that for their teddy bears. So I save these. I'll put them aside. And I will show you this first bit. Now, don't cut the burlap. All I'm going to do is scrunch this up, place it in my first chenille stem, and get it as tight as I can, and twist it into place. Now, I'm not putting this outside, but I do put deco mesh outside because it is plasticky, so if that makes sense, you just want to make sure it's really, really secure. So then all I'm going to do is basically make the burlap billow, and then I'm going to tuck these edges in, and then I normally try to go roughly 11 inches. Doesn't have to be perfect. And then I just squeeze, so roughly 11 inches, squeeze, poof it up, bring that little gather into the next available chenille stem. And I'm probably bumping you guys again because I feel burlap hitting my tripod. And then tighten it. Now, you don't want to cut those off either because you can use them. So you can see you get a nice billowy poof of burlap. Well, you can kind of see I turned it. So you get this poofy burlap that we can fuss with after. Just know that you just keep going and doing the same. So I'll do one more, and then I will jump off camera because this is going to bump my tripod again. And all right, so roughly from where I pinched it, roughly 11 to 12 inches. I'm gonna gather it up like so, pinch it. I always run my hand underneath the burlap because it doesn't have the wire in it like the deco mesh, and make sure that I'm making sure that it's turned the way I want. Okay, then all I do is set it down on that next chenille stem where the pinch is. Nice and tight, twist until you feel it's secure, and then you get something that looks like this. So I'm gonna finish this process all the way around, and I will be right back with you. Basically, I've done the whole thing the same way I showed you the first bit. So once you get to your last loop, you make the last loop, you tie it into where your first one started, and then you do your trim. So there's no right or wrong way to do this. I try to get from here, I give myself a couple of inches so I can wrap it around the back of the wreath form. That's just a personal preference because I like to make sure that I'm super duper secure. And this stuff is like, thank God these are my craft scissors. And this is where it gets interesting. Because you want to work from the bolt. You never want to cut it, because if you cut it, you're going to be short. Because you kind of just eyeball these poofs as you go to what looks good to you. Okay. Now, we have all of this still that I can use in another project, and I'm going to. So now I've got this nasty frayed end here. All I'm going to do is lift my loop, put it under that next loop, and tuck it down between my wreath form. And if it needs it, you can always grab another chenille stem and tie that down. All right. So now you're like, oh, but we can see the chenille stems. Now comes all the fluffing and fussing. Like I said, this is not as foolproof as deco mesh because there's not wires in it. But by the time I'm done decorating it, it will not be a problem. So basically all I'm going to do now is I'm going to go through and I'm going to fluff this very precariously. It's not going to be perfect. I'm going to take my chenille stems, wrap them around the back, tuck them into the wire form, and then I will be right back with you. Okay, so for some reason, every time I think I have my camera set and it's going to give me the full wreath, it zooms in a little as soon as it starts to record. So anyway, I've fluffed it. I've tucked all of those little excess pieces behind. If you can see any of your pipe cleaners or chenille stems or whatever you call them, just work the burlap until it gets, you know, judged in the right place. So this is the base of the wreath. Next, now this all came from Walmart. The next bit of stuff came from the Dollar Tree. So I have this flower. I have these two flowers. I don't know if I'm gonna use them, but they're here if I want to. And they are clip-on, so I could just clip them on, but I don't know. Actually, I don't have any Dollar Tree leaves. These leaves all came from Michael's. I got them on sale. So there's all those different leaves. These came from Dollar Tree. My little scarecrows. I don't know if I didn't get those this year. I got those last year, and I just had them in my stash. And then I have these sparkly mesh type leaves, so I'm going to be using those as well. So, as far as that goes, and then for ribbon, I have this grosgrain ribbon here. I bought something, and this was on the packaging, and I saved it. I got this burlap green ribbon for $2 at Walmart on clearance. And then I got this orange ribbon with this black satiny, it's not a wired edge, so it's going to be a pretty floppy ribbon. But it was $1 at Walmart on clearance. So you can always hunt those clearance sections. Get some deals. So I'm probably going to be layering my bow because the only one that really has wire is that burlap. So as far as I know, I haven't opened yet. But first up, what I'm going to do is pull these sticks out of these Dollar Tree. I mean, there's the Dollar Tree decoration thingy. I'm going to pull these sticks out of these styrofoam guys. And then I got some dowel rods. Maybe I won't be pulling those out. Oh, I think they go all the way. They go all the way up, so I can't pull them out. I really wanted to use them. Maybe I'll be using them. I'll probably just use them anyway and leave the stick sticking out the bottom of the wreath because it'll be cute. I don't think I'm going to use the green guy. I think I'm just going to use this guy because he seems more fall. Or she. He. It's got on pants. It's a he. I don't think it matters. So, let's see here. You can hear all this noise from all this packaging. All right. So what I'm going to do is take the tag off. All right. Now, let's say this is how I want my wreath to hang. I'm going to have his little stick go down this way. Now, I have two options when it comes to this bit. I can either glue him in like this, or I can use his stick with one of the chenille stems from that I tied around the back. You can't even really see it here. But right here, there's the chenille stem, so I can use that to wire his stick into my wreath, which will also, his legs, will cover. I'm going to grab that one that I had tied into the back. Get out of the way, leg. And the first thing I'm going to do is wire this in here because it'll give me a good, steady strength here. And then I'll just wrap that chenille stem back around, fluff my burlap back over it, lay his leg down, and no one's the wiser. And now he looks like a legitimate scarecrow because his little stick sticking out the bottom. The other thing I'm going to do is actually slap some hot glue under this top bit here. Just because this is burlap, I know it's going to seep through, so I am not sticking my fingers under there. Hot glue on the hand. So I'm going to lift him up a little, slap some hot glue on there, and just kind of mush him down. And whatever the hot glue touches, as it cools, I don't know why people say hot glue dries, it doesn't. Whatever he touches is what he's going to adhere to as that hot glue cools. So we're just gonna get my little stringies there. I'm gonna leave him and let him cool. So there we go. He's in there like Flynn. Now you could get really crazy about this and like glue his little legs going different ways. I don't care. I'm gonna leave them the way they are. I'm going to see if I want these flowers. I think I'm just going to clip these in. I don't even know if I'm going to need a ribbon on this guy. I think this might be good enough. Because this burlap has this these openings in it, so I can get these little clips through the burlap there. I don't know if you can see it. I'm going to use that little bit of his leg. Yeah, they're not going anywhere. I like that. Do I want the sunflower? I think the sunflower might be a little much. I'm going to leave the sunflower off. I have another project I'm pretty sure I'll use this on. So I'm going to leave that one off. But then I am going to take my leaves and kind of start to lay those in and see where I like them. I don't even know if this wreath's gonna get a bow. It might not even get a bow. Wouldn't that be crazy? And then, yeah, so what I think I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go around and put these fall leaves around the area here and just kind of spread them all around the wreath, and then I will be back. So basically I've decided to keep the leaves in little bundles around him, and then there's one
way down here, and I'm going to put my bow right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this aside, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to make my bow, and then I'll show you putting it on the wreath.
The burlap isn't wired, which I thought it was, but no big deal. So I'm going to take all three colors and lay them together. And then I'm going to make a pretty simple bow. I'm going to throw this bolt off to the side, same with this one, so that I can just see what I've got here. And you can see that burlap made a mess. But I want to keep these pretty well layered together, and then when I trim them, I'll give them all the little cut ribbon ends. So I'm going to do a pretty simple bow just because there's so much going on already with this one. And I don't want to use all of my ribbon because I have another project I want to do with you guys. But I want to... So what I'm going to do is I'm going to judge how big I want my loops. And then I'm going to tie it just like a pair of shoelaces with the old bunny ears. So this will keep my... So I've got my two loops here. Since this isn't wired ribbon, I can do it this way. If it was wired, I would do it a different way. Now, once I get everybody started here, I have a pipe cleaner. Actually, I have two, but I think I'm only going to need one. What I'm going to do is run it through this hole back here. And then I'm going to flip my tails. So I want all these tails to pull forward. And you do this during this step because this is what makes it easy to get all of your tails where you want them. So like this one's turned, so I'm just gonna work it into the direction that I want. And then stick my fingers back in here and pull tight. Now, that is really large. I don't need it that big. But if you notice, that locked in my chenille stem, and I don't have to do any extra fussing with that. So now all I have to do is grab my tails and adjust my loops. That one went a little too far. This is all you do. You just basically, I know some people are like, I am terrible at tying bows. But all I'm going to do is I'm going to keep fussing with it till I get it just the way I want it. And keep working this ribbon. Ribbon is really forgiving, guys. If you don't like it, you untie it and start over. Like, this part is starting to irritate me a little bit. I've been doing bows for a very long time. My mom has a shop, or used to have a shop on Etsy where she did flower arrangements. I know she still does them from time to time and opens her shop from time to time. She's actually Mother Daughter Flowers on Etsy, if you're curious. She taught me everything I know. And she does beautiful, beautiful work. And I used to be her primary bow attire. So I had a bodabra. I have been doing wreaths and bows and flower arrangements since I was, I think, about 15. She'll correct me if I'm incorrect in that information, but I think I was about 15. So that looks good to me. And the burlap is giving that some body. This one little piece down here is still twisting the wrong way. There we go. Maybe not. This is the longest bow tying adventure I've had in a while. I normally do really loopy bows, but I wanted this to look really casual because it's going on a burlap wreath. So that looks good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull my tails and I'm just going to do a ribbon end on them. You can do them all at the same time, or you can do them individually. Whatever you like. You can also do the little dovetail. I don't really care for a dovetail. That's just my personal opinion on something really casual. And I want this to not all be the same length on the ribbon ends. I kind of want them to go different ways. If you are worried about this satin, this ribbon here is sheer, it will fray. I'm going to hit it with a lighter. That will seal the ends. If you don't have a lighter, you can always use something like Fray Check, and that will prevent it from fraying as well. As well as this burlap, if you're worried about the burlap fraying. So, there's my bow. Now, if this part bothers you, which I'm kind of not in love with it, all I'm going to do is take this bit of brown that I have left, wrap it around the middle, bring it to the back. You have two options here. You can knot it, or you can use that pipe cleaner to seal it. I'm just going to knot it because I'm just going to leave the two little short brown bits as extra tails, and that's also going to pull that one single color in the middle. And then I'm just going to make sure that my ends are cut the way I want them. Holy moly, they were already. Okay, and then here is the back of my bow. And there's the front of my bow. Alrighty, that's a nice sound, into the garbage. Let me grab my wreath and I'll put it on there for you guys. I'm trying to get the camera angle just right, but it is causing me a little bit of a pain because this thing is so big. So what I've decided is right here where I tied in my scarecrow's post, I'm going to take my chenille stems. I'm going to go right around that same area. And I'm sorry guys, but I can't really lift it up to show you. But I am going to go right around that same area and just twist these in the back. And I'm sorry if you're wobbling because I did have to like severely rotate the camera here to get the angle that I wanted. Okay, so that's it. And then I've got my little tails going over here towards my leaves. You can fuss with it to have them go between the leaves or under the leaves or on top of the leaves. I'm probably going to do something in that neighborhood. And what I'll do now is I will do a quick pan over of the whole wreath so you can see it. As you see on my burlap, there's the bow, my clip-in flowers, and all of my little leaves. I'm happy with it at this point. It's pretty simple. And I like all the color, so I'm going to hang it up on the wall and I'll take a picture for you. Thanks for stopping by, guys, and we'll see you later. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more crafty videos. If you're interested in something for the holidays that you want to know how to do, leave a comment below and I will do my best to get that DIY crafty video up for you. So thanks so much. Bye guys.